Nigerian American philanthropist Toyo Dawodo has urged the Benin Republic government to immediately release Yoruba activist Sunday Adeyomo, also known as Sunday Igbowo, who is currently detained in the country's prison. Igbowo, who was arrested by the Republic of Benin authorities at the Benin airport on July 19, 2021, has since been in a detention facility in the neighboring country. Dawodo, in a statement issued on Tuesday, warned that the Beninese government must ensure that adequate release of the activist within 7 days or face serious consequences of the nature of an economic embargo that, as a country, it may never recover from in a very long time. The philanthropist stated that the continual remand of Igbowo, a popular figure among the Yoruba, might attract the fury of the people who are responsible for 80% of its revenue as a country in the last 60 years. This, he said, will have a negative impact on the economy of the neighboring West African state. Addressing journalists on Tuesday, Dawodo stated, "This briefing is intended to put pressure on the authorities of the Benin Republic to unconditionally release Sunday Igbowo within 7 days from the release of this statement or face serious consequences of the nature of an economic embargo that, as a country, may never recover from in a very long time. Whereas I am an American citizen of Nigeria descent, my heart has always been with the land of my origin, African, and particularly Nigeria. I believe strongly in truth, justice, and liberty. Hence the reason I have always supported in the past and present causes that promote human rights, justice, and the well-being of all Nigerians. I believe that Sunday Igbowo has not committed any offense by being an agitator for fairness and security for the Yoruba people of Nigeria. There is currently no law that is against a man's call for justice for his people. Therefore, I make this demand on the behalf of many Americans in diaspora, particularly of Yoruba origin, and all persons who detest injustice and oppression, that the Republic of Benin be mindful to do the following in the immediate. The Republic of Benin must immediately release Sunday Igbowo unconditionally, as he is being unnecessarily being persecuted by the Nigerian government on account of his political views, which do not constitute an offense, both in Nigeria and the Republic of Benin. The Republic of Benin must not, under any circumstances, hand over Sunday Igbowo to the Nigerian authorities for them to torture or dehumanize him. This is in tandem with the international law principle, which prevents a person that is fleeing political persecution to be forcefully returned to the country of persecution. The Nigerian justice system is inherently oppressive and systematically weak against the administration of President Muhammadu Buhari that has been famous for not obeying court orders. The Republic of Benin must allow Sunday Igbowo, after his unconditional release, to exercise his right to freedom of movement, and to that extent be free to travel out of the Republic of Benin to any country of his choice. It must be clear to the authorities of the Republic of Benin that the above demands are not mere wishes or with musicalities, as there is a strong network across the world that is prepared to visit serious economic sanctions on it as a country if it fails to honor its international human rights obligation to persecuted individuals like Sunday Igbowo. why it is also clear that the Benin Republic is afraid to offend the Nigerian government and therefore prepared to know or accede to the Nigerian government's demand to continue to detain Sunday Igbohu until he is returned to Nigeria. The Beninese authority forgot that, indeed, 80% of its revenue as a country in the last 60 years have come from imports made by Nigerians through the Haidiroko-Abeokuta border traders or trade. Republic of Benin must realize that Sunday Igbohu is an extremely popular figure among the Yoruba people of Nigeria, and they have been the ones principally engaged in the border trade, which have greatly enriched the Republic of Benin. Therefore, the Benin Republic must trade carefully not to offend the Yoruba people, or else the consequences of a trade embargo imposed by the Yoruba people against the Republic of Benin will spell an economic disaster to us as a country. There is a very capacity to ensure that this is carried out. In conclusion, it is maintained that Sunday Igbohu has not committed any offense against any law, whether national or international. The Republic of Benin must not lend itself to be used to carry out the persecution of an innocent man, a citizen of Nigeria, because of a political views. He must be released immediately. Sahara reporters in a series of reports stated that Igbohu escaped from a midnight raid on his Ibadan home by operatives of the DSS and later was arrested in Cotonou in the Benin Republic. His counsel, Chief Yomi Aliyu San, had filed a suit against DSS on Igbohu's behalf at the High Court in Ibadan. The court had been ordered the DSS to pay Igbohu the sum of 20 million naira as damages. Okay. Alright, someone said here, an innocent man fighting for the betterment of his people. No crime, nothing, just like my honorable president, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, my leader, till my last breath, I will always, you know, honor you people. Please, all BI friends and lovers of freedom should like our page, because we are going to do something. I don't know what they want to do. Yoruba have the power to do it. Without Yoruba land, Benin Republic is finished economically. Please, no need of sanction on Benin Republic. Yoruba is the second largest tribe there. Okay, someone said Sunday Igbohu is well known, a criminal. He is against the unity of our country. Innocent man fighting for the total freedom of his people and Africa at large. Both Sunday Igbohu and Nnamdi Kanu supposed to be recognized as heroes in Africa, not to be betrayed by African leaders. So guys, these are some reactions by Nigerians. I'm dropping it here. Kindly drop your view below the comment section. Thank you very much for always stopping by. Bye for now.